Hello everyone, myself Prithviraj P. Tambe, working as an assistant professor in Department of Electronics Engineering at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Let us learn today programmable ROM. At the end of this session, you can examine the general structure of programmable read-only memory. You can implement simple Boolean functions using PROM. So let us first understand what is a PROM. So PROM is a combinational programmable logic device. An integrated circuit with fixed AND array and a programmable OR array. So PROMs are used to provide AND OR, that is SOP implementations. So let us learn the structure of PROMs. So we have here input lines which are connected to the fixed AND array through some buffers and inverters. The output of these fixed AND arrays are connected to programmable OR arrays, and again the output of OR arrays are again made available to the users through these output lines through some inverter and buffer combinations. So if you compare structure of PROM with the remaining PLDs, you will observe that the AND array is fixed, whereas OR arrays are programmable. So this fixed AND array is very similar to a decoder structure. So let us go further. So first, fixed AND array structure. From n number of inputs and their complements, multi-input AND gate array produces maximum 2 raised to n number of AND terms. Again, this number is limited, but you can see here an example of an AND array in PROMs. So here you will see it's a 3-input function A, B, C are connected through the inputs of these AND gates, and the connections are fixed here. So this black dot represents a fixed connection. So for this particular 3-input system, you can have maximum 8 combinations, as 2 raised to 3 is the relation. So you can have maximum 8 AND terms, that is main terms. Programmable OR array. So the AND terms, or more specifically main terms from the AND arrays, are fed to the programmable OR array, and this is used to realize a set of output in SOP form, more specifically in the canonical form. So let us implement some functions. So number of main terms are fixed, as we have saw in the fixed array slide. So let us implement a simple Boolean function using PROMs. So from this AND array slide, we know that the mean terms are fixed. So a set of Boolean expressions need not to be minimized, as AND array is fixed. So we have mean terms output of AND array. So this realization of a set of Boolean functions is totally based on the mean terms and not on the product terms. So here user can program the fuses of OR array depending upon the mean terms, and the final realization is totally based on SOP expressions. So let us implement some Boolean functions. So here we have f1 is equal to ab, f1 which is function of ab having mean terms 0, 1 and 3. So let us find out the mean terms for this given function. So the mean terms for f1 are a bar b bar, a bar b, and ab. So f1 is nothing but a bar b bar plus a bar b plus ab. Let us implement one more function f2, which is a function of ab. The given mean terms are 0 and 2. Let us write down the mean terms for f2. So f2 is a bar b bar plus a b bar, which is in a canonical form as both the terms are mean terms. So if you observe f1 and f2, both functions are in canonical form. They are made up of only mean terms. So no minimization is required when implementing any Boolean function using PROMs. So this is the final diagram of these two function implementations. So here you will see that for two variable function, the PROM used have four AND gates, and as we required to implement, as we need to implement two functions, we require two ORs, and the OR array is programmable, whereas AND array is fixed. So two inputs, four main terms or four AND gates. So the function f1 is a bar b bar plus a bar b plus ab. So here you will see that the output of the first AND gate is a bar b bar, the fuse is intact. Output of the second AND gate is a bar b, again the fuse is intact. Output of the third AND gate is a b bar, but this term is not part of f1, that's why this fuse is blown. Next, the output of this fourth AND gate is a b, again this term is a part of f1, so the fuse is intact. So output of the first OR gate is nothing but our function f1. So only three fuses kept intact and one is blown away. Similarly for f2, we have two terms, a bar b bar plus a b bar. So again the output of first AND gate is reused here, which is a bar b bar, so the fuse is kept as it is. Output of second and fourth AND gates are not part of this equation, that's why those two fuses are blown away. Again output of third AND gate, which is a b bar, which is a part of f2 function, that's why this fuse is kept as it is. So f2 is made up of these two mean terms, that's why these two mean terms are kept as it is. The remaining fuses are blown away. So this is how you can implement simple Boolean functions using programmable read-only memories. These are the textbooks which you can refer for the further reading. Thank you.